As we're walking to an ATM, I glance over at the bikes, and they just don't look right. And I tap, like, hey, Ian, look at the bikes. And instead of being like this, they're just on their sides. Just two bikes laying on their sides. Our life, basically, laying on the sides of the parking lot. I don't know if they've been hit, they've been robbed, they've been whatever.
Now we have to lift them up.
Yes, they're fucking heavy. 600 pounds, awkward shit.
As soon as we get the bikes up, I'm like frustrated. Whoever it was just left, there's no car next to us, like a hit and run. And I'm just like, damn it, I'm finding pieces of my bike broken. And then of course what happens? It starts to rain. And then we can't get out of the parking lot that we were in. There was like, we had some card and we're putting it in this thing to get out of the parking lot. The gate doesn't open. And it's like one of those moments where I'm like, so embarrassed and pissed and frustrated. And I realized we have 80 days left. I'm like, I don't want to do this anymore.
What's up?
What's going on?
Dude. I hear you got a phone call yesterday.
Oh yeah, yeah.
What happened?
So he called and he couldn't get in through Mexico.
This is my first like minor meltdown. One of probably many to come in Mexico. We had to pay $400.
So I answered it and it was Pat, like all stoked and, hey Pat! And he's like, no, I gotta like get charged $3 a minute.
I pull out the old Visa card, swipe it, nothing. Doesn't work.
Was he stuck at the border?
Like, yeah, he was at the border, and I think he was like at the like clerk window or whatever, trying to get through.
So I finally had to call Marsden Sawyers at the media office on his iPhone.
So I had to have him give me the phone number to his bank. We had to merge calls.
And just, you can't call like an 800 number on the damn international plan on a phone. How frustrating is that?
You know what's great about that? This is the first border crossing of, I think, 16, and they run into these problems on the first one.
I took care of my bank, and I told the guy in the other line, like, hey, this is who I am, this is what's going on, you know, can we handle this as fast as possible, because this is literally costing me, every 4 minutes I'm on the phone with you is $10, and I know this can take a while. And he had no hurry whatsoever, just couldn't have given a shit. I think he actually talked slower. God, I just wanted to crush my phone, fly in a plane, punch Ralph in the face, and drive back down. We found this RV park, which online, another lesson learned, looks beautiful online, in service, hookups, internet. And we get there, and the thing's just locked up tight as a drum. It's like Fort Knox. Pull up. There's not a single light on it, looks dead. There's not a single person walking around. It's like a ghost town. And we're right by this main road ripping by in Hermosillo, and we're just parked on the bikes like two dumbasses at night in Mexico, sitting on the side of the road, just fucked.
Sun's going down. We have no one here. I don't know. We gotta figure out where the hell we're gonna stay tonight. Right now it's not looking good, a little grim.
Don't know anyone, don't know what we're gonna do. I have no place to stay, and it's pitch black outside. And I was just like, I just felt like such an amazing loser. Just such a loser.
I saw on Twitter last night, Pat's like, we don't have a place to stay. It's like 7:30. I'm like, oh shit, I wish I could help him, but.
As hard as it is for me to do, I had to kind of admit idiocy and admit failure and ask for help. And so sent out a blast on social media to Twitter, you know, Black Hawk down. And just said, hey, this is where we are, and we need help.
But I just got a tweet from Rich Froning's father, Mr. Froning, the original, answered my distress call. Brother, I'm in Destin. It's a bit wet, though.
Dude, within 5 minutes, somebody responded, and he had somewhere to go.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he said his campsite's full. We're in Mexico, and he had some name that I've never heard of the town. Can somebody please help us out? And then the very next post, it's like, we're saved.
I got a text from our guys and say, hey, there's two guys from CrossFit HQ that are just in the middle of nowhere.
I was working in the hospital, and I was about to check out, you know, finish my duty.
And I saw the mention, oh, there's two guys home alone in Hermosillo on the highway. And like call for me, no, are you going to pick up this guy? Well, and say, yeah.
So you guys in the middle of the highway, sitting in the, I mean, you were about to get robbed, man, or something.
Dude, like the CrossFit community, you kidding me? Yeah. People around the world, to include Rich Froning Sr., are like making sure everything's kosher. So cool.
You almost can't put it into words until you experience it. It means the world. It means the world when someone, total strangers, just open their arms and say, come on over. You do CrossFit, we do CrossFit, we love the community, you're your family now.
You guys have benefited from the community as well. You know, both of you guys told me your stories, you know, showed me your pictures, so yeah, well, tell me what, you know, how you've benefited from the CrossFit.
You're looking at almost 80 pounds less yeah. in between both of us. I lost more than 40, Tico lost probably 50.
Dude, they made us shirts. Like, they made us shirts that said, like, CrossFit and 3-2-1 go south on it, and like, it's just so touching.
When you come to the to train CrossFit, you start suffering in the training, but you start suffering with some other people, and you are in pain, but the guy next to you is in pain yeah. also. And I don't know. I think that situation open you to the next person because this person next to you is telling to you like, hey, come on, you can get there, let's do it.
And they had a dude there who left out a piece of gear when in just like left, you know, like left a barbell, I went home. So they posted it on Facebook a while ago and said, hey, for every like this gets, this guy will do a burpee over the box for leaving the gear out. It got like 541 likes. So this guy showed up to literally just get his balls kicked through his throat and do 541 over the box burpees.
Group photo or something. I told the guy like, let's be chill. Yeah. And now there's like 100 people here. Yeah. Dude, that was cool as hell, man. CrossFit is alive and well in Mexico. Yeah. Alive and well. We're at CrossFit 52 Hermosillo, and we threw down a team wad. It was fun as shit. Everyone was cheering for the lady trying to climb the rope up the end. We'd never met each other. They're like having fun picking teams. Like, it was super cool start to finish. Like, hot as shit, but fun as hell, man. It's great down here.
Dude, we had a blast with those guys, and they took great care of us like we were family. And we've got friends if we ever go back. And any CrossFitter that ever just wanders into that town, look those people up, man. You won't regret it.